Hilchus Shvi Sasser, Perek Revi. Ein mitzien es ha'esh, leimun ha'itzim, v'leimun ha'avonim, v'leimun ha'matchas. In other words, to create fire, not by lighting it from an existing flame, but to create new fire, that's osur on yontif. Kigoyin, sh'chich en oysen zu bezu, you rub them one against the other, imak zu bezu, or you bang them against each other, at sh'teitzi ha'esh, v'chein ha'neft, ha'chad b'yeser, shehu kimayim, you have very clear kerosene, which you shake it in a certain manner, and that causes, they're very combustible, and therefore that causes them to light on fire without an existing flame. A kli zach kosher, you have a clear, hard keli. Is chuchas mleyamayim, you have a glass full of water. Shemanich noise keneged ein hashemesh. It's like we'd use a magnifying glass. You'd have a glass of water, and the rays of the sun are being directed, going towards the glass of the water, and through that, they are redirecting those rays and intensifying them, that they should be able to light something like flax, something which is very flammable because of the concentration of the heat. We're creating a fire, not from an existing fire. It's called ze ukiyetze be'os be'ontif. In our world, it would be simple to strike a match, but to open a fire on a stove to open a new fire. So that would be without coming from an existing fire. That's usher. Why? Shalihuter be'ontif el lahavir me'esh mitzuya. Aval lahamti esh usher. Shariyev shalahamti be'esimer be'ontif. On Shabbos, on Yontif, Mavir is Mutar on Yontif. It's even Mutar Shalei Letzerech, we learned earlier. However, it's only Mavir of creating a fire from an existing fire. But to create a new fire is not something necessary, because a new fire could have been created out of Yontif. Now, the Mice is, Mitzad Hilchus Havvara, there's really no difference if you create a new fire or you take an existing fire and you light up, if you light it, either to light a match or to light a match from a candle. There's really no difference. It's just that lapel, when you're lighting a match, so to speak, so you're creating something, and that's not necessary. So therefore, Chazal were asked, it's Yisud Rabbanim the Pashtus, not Yisud Reis, the Pashtus. Halacha Beis. Avo bi shahutra havara bi yontif shalei l'tzeirach. Havara is mutter even shalei l'tzeirach. Aber also l'chabis isha'esh. Afilo huver l'tzeirach achila. Kibuy is also. Havar is mutter, and kibuy is also. And even if you mean mechaba and esh, which you lit l'tzeirach achila, so l'chur, there's certain haterim, which you're allowed to do if you did it l'tzeirach achila, so you're allowed to, l'mashal, if you traveled somewhere, you could come back, because if you're not going to be able to come back, you're not going to travel in the first place, and therefore they will matter for you to come back. So al-derazah, you could think that maybe there's a heter of kibuy, because it was necessary for you to be maver, and if you're not going to be able to be mechaba, you won't go ahead and be maver. So here's the chiddush: afilo huver l'tzeirach achila tzosos, shakibuy melacha ve'ein be'tzeirach achila klal. So the Rambam says clearly that there's no musig of kibuy l'tzeirach achila. There's a shaila, because later on we're going to learn that when you put a dover meat on top of yecholim in order to roast, so you're doing kibuy as well. Al-Khura, that's mutter. So the question is, the Rambam is saying that ain't by tzerech achila klal. The mice is that there's the Achreinim explained that the pshat is that be'emes, the Rishenim also, that the emes is that kibuy is not a kibuy gomer. There's no musig of a kibuy gomer, which is l'tzerech achila. That kibuy is not a kibuy gomer, and that's why it's mutter. But kibuy itself is taka, there's no musig of kibuy l'tzerech achila, and therefore we're going to learn that even if the mashal, according to the Rambam, if you have a fire, and that fire is causing the meat to get ruined, and merely by turning off the fire, you'll be able to save the meat. That's also usher, because the kibui knows when you light a fire and you tzeirach achila, so pshas, the fire is going to go into the food. The heat of the fire is going to go into the food. Over here, the kibui is only preventing the loss. The kibui is only preventing the loss, so that doesn't go into the gather of tzeirach achila. And since it doesn't go into Tzeirach Achila, so it's Aser, it goes into a gather of Machshiri Eichel Nefesh. And Machshiri Eichel Nefesh, according to the Rambam, is Machshiri Eichel Nefesh, even, which was Efshel HaSeisim Erev Yontiv, is Aser on Yontiv. That's a big machlekes. The Rambam holds that's how it's an issue in Shitas Rambam as well. But the pashtus of Loshna Rambam is the Makshiri Echol Nefesh Afilu, if Eav Shal Aseisin Me'erev Yontiv, is Osir on Yontiv. And therefore, Kibui always goes into a gather of Makshiri Echol Nefesh. And even if it's Litzerich Yontiv, Abu Lepeil, it's not considered something which is Mutter. Nachamo. Aval Pi Shehutra Avare Biyontiv Shalei Litzerich, Osir Lechabis Isoesh, Afilu Huvera Litzerich Achila, Shak Kibui Melocha, Ve'em Be Tzerich Achila Kal. There's no musig of Kibui which is Mutter Litzerich Achila. Kshem Shem Mechabna Soesh, Kachem Mechabna Saner, Dem Kibu Leke Kemesha Ora Gibbona. Kibui is always Osir. Halacha Gimul. Aim is salkin pia ner lemaila kidei shetichba, to pull up the wick higher so it should go out of the shemen and eventually and obviously immediately become extinguished. That's usr. They misidin sashem mimenu, to take out the oil out of the candle. They nichoitech es reis apsilu bekeli, to cut the top of the wick with a keli is usr. Avul noifes es reis shabiyod. You know, the top, you have the charcoal on top. You want to take that charcoal off to be able to light the psila again. So biyadi, that's mutter. Aguda shaleitzim shahud l'ka b'medura. If you have a bundle of wood, that part of that bundle is now lit, is kol eitz shaleitzim z'behoesh mutter l'shamte. Because that piece of wood has nothing to do with the rest of the piece of wood. You have five pieces of wood in a bundle, and one or two pieces of wood was lit with fire. So you could take away the other eights. Because when you have shemen in there and you're taking out some of the shemen, so he said before, you're not allowed to. Mashenkin over here, taking away a piece of wood from this bundle that the fire didn't light, is mutter. Now the pashtus, the shemen, is all the shemen is in the ner, so the fire is coming from all the shemen. Agam, l'chur, you have to also come on to this vart, that when you take out the shemen, so the fire becomes shvacher. The Alter Rebbe Tager writes now in Shulchan Aruch that if you have a bundle of wood, you have wood, a few pieces of wood, and the fire is on all the pieces of wood, and now you take them apart, and lepel, each piece of wood still has fire. Originally they had fire together, now you're taking them apart, and each one has separately fire. So that's also usher, because the fire that they have together is a greater fire than the fire that each one has separately. Also, that the fire which all of them has together is greater than the fire that each one has separately. So al derech is over here, when you take out the oil from the candle, so the fire is a shvachar of fire. I mean, by wood, it's easier to understand because you have five pieces of wood that are lit, and they're all five together, it's create a greater fire. Over here, l'chur, you have a psila that's coming from a little oil. The little oil that's going into the psila is what's going in. Either there's a big keli, it might not come in if there's a big keli, but l'peil, Chazal teaches differently, that when you take out oil from a keli, so the fire that's being lit over there is shvacher. The Rambam doesn't say that here. I'm not going to say that in Hilchos Shabbos either, but that's l'chur de pshat. That's the chilik. In a dema, l'meisa shemen min haner. Because the nakudas advarim is you're not allowed to take out oil from a candle, even though the candle continues burning. You're allowed to take away wood from a pile of wood, if that, or from a bundle of wood, if that wood was, and even though the bundle of wood is on fire, but since this piece of wood is not on fire, so therefore you can take it away. Halacha dalet. Ein mechabnes adleika kedei lahatz. So there's an isser of kibui. There's an isser of kibui. There's an eishes mutter, the kudz advarim, eishes mutter, but only from an existing fire, not to light a new fire. And kibui is usser under all circumstances. Ein mechabnes adleika kedei lahatz al mamen biyantav. Kedei lahatz al mechabnes b'shabtz. That also, kibui is usser. So the fact that you're going to lose money doesn't change anything. Now there's a svara, the Ham doesn't say such a svara, but there's other places bring a svara that if, let's say, the place where you're supposed to eat is going to burn down. So l'chure, so you bring mechaba in order to be able to eat. But al kobam, the Ramah doesn't write such a svara. Ela manicha v'yetza. And also it's brought down, the nachreinim is brought down that bizman hazeh, there's more of a cooling kibui from a dleika because of a chshash of sakonis nefoshes. which is Tashu Shamita is also Lefnei Haner. The Eitz is to put a keli on it, obviously in a way that you don't smother the fire. But you keif olav keli, that the Nair shouldn't be there. The light of the Nair shouldn't come in. Oy, another option is Oysa Mechitza B'nei Levein Haner. That's a second option. And the third option is Eimitzil by Yisach, which is the easiest, the best option. The main Yochalas is Achas Mikolelu. In other words, not to be keif olav keli, not to make a Mechitza, not to take it out. Is a reza also lechabes and also lishamish ad shetich b'meila. Muter lahtaltel saner v'hu delik ve'en gezel shema yichbe. V'also lohaniach es saner al gabi hadelik u kietze b'biyontif. It means an erev yontif. Also of some agiris u kietze b'erev yontif. You're not allowed to leave a candle burning on top of a tree. Why? Because shema yavi. Because if there is a candle on top of a tree, you're not allowed to go and take the candle off the tree because that's being mishtamish with the tree. So you're not allowed to leave the candle even on Erev Yontif. Ein ma'ashnen b'k'teiris b'yontif. To put k'teiris on top of coals in order to create a nice scent, nice reach, is osra on Yontif. Why m'pnei shum mechaba? Because by putting k'teiris on top of the coals, you're being mechaba the coals. Va'afilu l'ariach, but even your intent is to smell this clay, so it's going directly to you. So nevertheless, it's awesome. Ein tzorich lemer is legamris habayis v'sakelim shu osu. You want the house with the kelim should have a nice scent, that's for sure osu. Kitsu, you're not allowed to put k'teiris on coals on your tongue. Why? Because of the isur of mechaba. Aber muter l'ashim tachas ha'peiris k'dei sheyukshu. If you put something under, you're putting k'teiris under peiris, on top of coals and under peiris, and through that is k'dei sheyukshiru l'achila, that's mutter. K'moi shemutter litzlis basar leish. Just like you're allowed to roast meat, see, even though by roasting the meat there's a mechaba, but nevertheless, you're allowed to because it's l'tzera chachila. So here also, you're allowed to make k'teiris on top of coals, on top of coals. But Nachamol, if this would be a mechabe gomur, so then it would come out that you're being mechabe, emes a kibui, l'tzeir chechol nefesh. Then kibui should become mutter, maybe afil l'shalei l'tzeir. The Rambam makes it very clearly that there's no such mitzias of a kibui l'tzeir chechol nefesh. Therefore, kibui is absolutely osir. I l'chure basar tzoli is mutter. The answer is because it's not kibui gomur. So a mashn b'kteir is beyond to because I'm playing shemachaber, even though it's not a kibui gomer, it's mechaber, and therefore it's osur. Mashen and it's not l'tzeir chechol nefesh. The mice has been again k'teir. There's another issue because it's not a tzeirich. It's not shavah l'chol nefesh. It has to be a something which is shavah l'chol nefesh. The Rambam doesn't mention that the reason why there's a problem in Shulchan Aruch is brought down that the problem of k'teir is another problem. It's not a something which is shavah l'chol nefesh. And it has to be something which is shavah l'chol nefesh, like oichol nefesh. But al kol pon, in the Rambam itself, the pashtus advarim is you can't put coals, you can't put k'teiris on top of coals because it's mechaba, and it's mechaba, so it's usher. But again, putting k'teiris on top of coals k'dei la'ashen saperis is mutter. The Rambam says k'moy shemutter litzlis baser aloish because and l'chur it's kibui. The answer is it's not a kibui gomer. That has to be the answer l'chur. Because we're going to learn that even omematkin es hachardel begachelus shel matches, there's to take chardel mustard. If you put a coal into the mustard, that makes the mustard sweet. Now, kibui the kibui min hatera is only by agachelus shel eitz. Agachelus shel matches. If you don't have kavana to make the matches stronger, there's no din of kibui because there's no real pechon. So memela. So mematkin is a chardel b'gachelus shel matches, avolei b'gachelus shel eitz. Again, mepnei shu mechaba, by putting this into the chardel, you're being mechaba the gachelus. They mechaba nusayish k'dei shleitis ashna k'dei reyabais. Even though you're talking about food, so ain mechaba nusayish k'dei shleitis ashna k'dei. Kibui gomur is usur, because kibui is considered a machshir yechol nefesh, even if yef shel aseis merev yontif, mashal over here, you have the fire, you weren't able to make this kibui out of yontif, nevertheless, it's osur. Shalit tesash nagdeir, yabai, that's l'chura what comes out. Halacha zayin. Ein neufchen b'mapuach b'yontif, k'dei shal yaseh k'derech sha'um n'nesen. There's to blow out fire with bellows, which causes the fire to become greater. So the chure, havar is mutter. But over here there's a problem that it's k'derech sha'um n'nesen. Avul neifchen b'shrifer is to use a regular straw. And to be nefer, that's mutter. But because mitzadik, there's no iser on the havar, there's no extra iser on the havar. It's only k'derech sha'um n'nesen. To make charcoal, vein goydel sapsila to braid a wick, v'lei mahavneisa to singe a wick to make the wick better, v'lei tchet chneisa l'shnayim bekeli. All of these things are you're doing things which are machshiri echel nefesh, maybe, and it's also because you're making a keli. V'lei tchet chneisa l'shnayim bekeli. Avul memacha biyat. Notice if you have a wick and you want to soften it, biyad, that you're allowed to do. And the sheira isa b'shemen, umaniach isa bin shtei neiris, umadlik b'amtza, you want to have two wicks. So instead of going and cutting the two wicks, you put the two ends of the wick into two separate neiris, you put it in oil, and then you light it in the middle. So mamela, each wick will go to the other keli, to one keli. V'namtzas apsila nechlekas b'fishtei ha-neiris. Yeah. So the kids are, so he's saying, kibuy, we're learning kibuy is usher. And also to make things like to to be gadol sapsila, to be chet chesul shnayim, that's also us. Halacha ches ein shevrim es acheres vein chet chnus aniyar nelitzis aleim. Again, this machshirei echol nefesh, which was afshel aseisim erev yontiv. But even if you afshel aseisim erev yontiv, you're not allowed to. Ein because so you're breaking off a piece of cheres to be able to roast on top of it. Or a piece of niyor, we normally touch niyor means paper, but it means obviously paper, which you could roast on, a different type of paper than we're used to. Vein poitzen esakona, to take a reed and split it. La'aseisi kimei shpud litzlis b'moliach, in order to make it into a spit. Shpud shenirtzaf, if the shpud became bent. Avo pishu yochel l'pashti b'yodi, you don't need a keli, you could do it with your own hands to straighten it out. Ein mesakon nesi, again, because it's makshiri echol nefesh, and it's even though if shall aseisim erev yontiv, the Rambam holds you're not allowed to. The Pil Halacha is brought down that if it happened and if shall aseisim erev yontiv, you are allowed to because the Halacha is that machshir echel nefesh if shall aseisim erev yontiv. There is a heter for it. Shnei kelim shem mechubarim betchilas asiyosim ke shnei neiris or shnei cases ein pechsin eisim lishnayim mipnei shukim esakim kelim, to take something that's lachatchila two kelim into one and make it into two kelim mamish, you're not allowed. Halacha test. Ein mashchizin es hasakin b'mashchezes shelo. To use a knife sharpener, you're not allowed to. Avon mechadido al gabi ho'etz, al gabi cheres or yeven, things which is not the derech, you could make it a little sharper. And even this din is ein meidin davizel rabim. To sharpen a knife, not kederech, with a knife sharpener is mutter, but ein meidin davizel rabim. Kidei shel yaveo lechadido b'mashchezes. B'med vor mamurim that you're allowed to be mechadido. With shlei kederech, with an eitz or a cheres or a even is b'shiachel lachtik b'deicha keshaniv gema. Whereas be'ames it could cut. It's not cutting so well, or there's a little begima there. Avlam eini yachel lachtik chlal. So it became uis. It's not a sakim. So then ein mashchizin is afil al eitz. Why? Because shema yaveil mashchizin mashchezes and being mash and to mashchizin mashchezes when it's b'chlal ain't. I'm not sure if that's the pshat. I'm not sure if that's right. I was thinking the pshat is that if it's any yechel lachtik chlal, so then the hashchaz is more of an iser. But here the Rambam is saying differently. Avol any yechel lachtik chlal, ein mashchizin es afilu eitz, because shem yaveil hashchizin mashchezes. So over here there's more of a kshash, because since any yechel lachtik chlal, so therefore here there's more of a kshash that you're going to go lashchizin mashchezes. Mashainkin, if it is cutting. And it's only a question, it's not cutting so well, so we're not so concerned that you're going to go and be mashchiz of mashchezes. Mipnei zeh, because of this iser of being mashchiz a sakin, is also laharis sakin lechokin biyantiv. Why? Koshem etiyah b'guma. V'yeymer lei also lishchid bo mishum gimosa. V'yeyle v'yichadadan of mashchezes. And over here he's going to want to be, because with the b'gima it's in gantz no good. So there's a concern that yelech yichadadan b'mashchezes, like we're saying. If you have a sakin which doesn't work at all, there's always a concern, yichadadan b'mashchezes. So over here, since this sakin is a sakin of shchit and it has a b'gima, So over here, there's more of a concern. So therefore, you're not allowed to be mara a sack into a chacham to tell you if it's good or not. Because of the chash, you may go ahead. If it'll tell you it's no good, be chadidan of mashchezus. The chacham shiro a sack la'atzmei is a reza mashil la'maritz, because then there's no chash. He has a sack which is to say halacha yud. Ein mevakin etzim biyontif, to chop wood. No, it's not to chop wood. No, it's to take wood and to cut it up. Le bekardum, not with a hatchet. Le bemagel, with a sickle. Le bemegera, and with a saw. Ela bekupitz. Kupitz is a keli, which is a butcher knife, but something like a butcher axe. Ubitzad hachad shalei. This butcher's kupitz has two tzadim, more the wider part and the narrower part. So you should use the wider part would be easier to cut the wood because it's wider. So you shouldn't use the wider part. You should use the tzad achad shalei. Avalei b'tzad harachiv mepnei shulki kurdim. Because the tzad harachiv, even of a butcher's knife, looks like a hatchet. What's the problem of chopping this wood? Because you're not making really a keli, you're just breaking it apart. This could have been done erev yontif, so therefore it shouldn't have been done on yontif. You were able to do it on erev yontif. So if you were able to do it on yontif, we're concerned that you may end up having a thick piece of wood, and you're not going to be able. The fire is not going to be able to get onto it, and memele v'yimanim levashel, and memele you're not going to have simchas yontif. So therefore, Chazal were matal. So in other words, over here we're saying that Be'amis, you could have done it on Erev Yant. So therefore, Chazal asserted something which he should have done and could have done on Erev Yant. But on the other hand, since there's a concern that right now you're in a matzah that you may not be able to eat because you're not able to do it, and it's not really an Isser Gomer, this chopping of this wood is not really an Isser. So therefore, Chazal asserted on a regular way, but B'derech Shini, it's mutter. So there are many other isurim and many other dinim which Chazal asserted because you should, even though it's not an isur gomer, but it's asur me'erev yont, you should have done it on erev yont, and therefore you shouldn't do it on yont. If since it's letzerech and if you're not going to be able to do it al yedei shinui, so you're going to be missing simchas yont. Chazal will matter al yedei shinui. Halacha Yud Aleph. Leiti konis isha bein ha'etzim, little mehem ud litzlizbei. So wood, she shouldn't go into the woodshed to take a piece of wood in order to roast with. Now, the Rambam doesn't say it, but the Magen Mishnah says that we're talking about a piece of wood that's wet. Because if this piece of wood is roy to use for firewood, so l'chura, why shouldn't she be able to use litzlizbei? Just like we learned that if you have a kites, and you have a thorn, you could use for a shpud. If the thorn is a dry thorn, because even though it wasn't aimed for shpud, you can use it for a shpud. So we hear also, l'churi, you should be able to use it to roast. So the Ram doesn't say it, but the Magen Mishnah says that the pshad is, we're talking about a wet piece of wood. V'ein seimchen es ha'gdera, v'lei es ha'delis, v'baka'as shelkera. To take this baka'as shelkera, even though you're allowed to use it for firewoods, but to use it to be same with the gedera or the del, is that you're not allowed to? Shli itiru letaltel etzim biyontiv ela lasaka buvat. The heter is only lasaka buvat. So the pashtus we read it is going on both sai leisikonis isha and on vein seimkun. But according to the Magen Mishnah, leisikonis isha min etzim is because it's not oimed lasaka. It's not oimed lasaka, because if it would be oimed lasaka, she would be allowed to. Mashenke, the second halacha, that's not the pashtus halosh, but that's the Magen Mishnah teaches. But the second halacha is talking about eitz, which is aimed la soka, and it's like a new din. No, it's a keli, which is aimed for anything. Keli is, you could be used, let's say, a gufe, even for something that's not aimed by. Mashenke, a piece of wood, which is not a keli, so it could only be used for what it's aimed by. And since it's only aimed la soka, so you can't use it in order to be same as a gedera or to be same as a delos. Halacha Yud Beis. Now they used to have like little boots a booth outside in the Rishus HaRabim, and that would be like called a chanus, a store. It would be a closed booth, and they would sell things from it. And that closed booth would have a door to it or a window to it. They would take off the window or the door from this booth, and that's how they would take the things out, and then they would put it back. Now, these booths, some of them had hinges. Some of them didn't have any hinges at all. You just had a piece of wood, and you put it back on. Then some of them had a hinge in the middle. In other words, let's say on top of the piece of wood, which is being used as a door to this booth. And on the bottom, that would be in the middle. And then some of them had hinges on the sides. Now, if it has a hinge in the middle, so there's no real concern, because you always have to take it out of the hinge. In other words, a hinge means over here, you have like a little piece of metal sticking out on top, and a piece of metal sticking out on bottom, and then you'd put it in the holes that are in the booth. That's how you would hold it. So since you would always have to take it off and put it on, so you'd never really make it very tight, because you always have to take it off and take it on. Masha'inkin, if you have these little pieces of metal sticking in and sticking out on the side, the hinges would be on the side, so then you'd be able to turn it open. So there's more of a concern of putting it in more tightly. You could have a booth with a door to it or a window to it. Now that window you're taking off, a window made out of, there's an opening with a wood covering, and you're taking it off. It could be either without a hinge or with a hinge in the middle, which is not really such a concern of making it tight. And then the hinge on the side, which is more of a concern of making it tight. Halacha Yud Beis. Misalkin trisi chanuyas. If you're talking about a chanus in the street, you could take it off. Umachzir neisim biyontif, and you could return it. Kedei sheyetzi tavlin shutzorech lehem, that you take out spices that you need. Min hachanus b'leimonim b'simchus yontif. Is taking it out is not a problem. The problem is putting it back. So putting it back, there's a chashash, and maybe you can make it tight. So he says, no, b'medvar mamurim, that you're allowed to put it back, b'shiyesh lehem tzir b'amtza. If the tzir is in the middle, so there's not really a serious concern that you're going to put it back tightly. Aviyesh lehem tzir min atzad, but if the tzir is on the side, is also because it's gzeira shamayitka. And v'shein lehem tzir kolikar, however, if we're dealing with a chanus that doesn't have any tzir, it's just a piece of wood you put on and put off, is a fila b'bayis, in the street, there's a concern that maybe if you're not going to be allowed to put it back, so therefore, if you're not allowed to put it back, so then you won't take it off. So therefore, they will matter to put it back in order for you to take it off. Mashengin b'bayis l'chure, why should you take it, put it back? L'chure in the bayis, you're not afraid to take it off. It's in your house anyways. So no one's going to take anything away from there. So therefore, in the bayis, you're not allowed to put it back. You're allowed to take it off, but you're not allowed to put it back. If it doesn't have any hinge, so then I feel a b'bayis mutalavs. It's no chamol. If it's in the street, so if it has a hinge in the middle, you can take it off and put it up back on. If it has a hinge on the side, you can't put it back on. You can take it off, but you can't put it back on. In the house, you could never put it back on unless it has no hinge. So then you can put it back on as well. Halacha Yud Gimel. Kelim shehein mifutzalim. You have a keli that's made of different parts. Is mamidin eisen b'yontiv? You can set up this keli on yontiv. You're not allowed to put in the pieces together very tightly. You put it up, you can put it together, but not very tightly. When you don't put something tightly, that's not called binyan. If you want to set up a besakise, so you're setting up a kise. Now you don't have a kise, you need a kise to relieve yourself. So you're setting up some avonim, and that avonim is going to become a chair. It'll be the kise. That'll be the kise where a person will sit. So avonim shul beis kise mutar litzad lembiyantel, to set up this kise, to have a kise to be able to sit on, to relieve yourself. Binyan arayu umishum kvedele gozu. Even though normally you're not allowed to build things, but over here it's a binyan aray, and mishum kvede is le gozu, it's covered abris. Halacha Yud Dalet. Ha'isa madura b'yantiv, when you're making a fire on yantiv, is k'shu ha'oyru ha'itzim, eini maniach zeh al gav zeh, ad sheyazder hamarocha. You're setting up the wood, one on top of the other, b'pnei sh'nira k'beini. You're building a fire, so you're building wood, you're building like a whole marocha of wood. It's nevertheless osur. What should you do? You just spill the wood and there's haphazardly. You set it up a shino. You start from the top. You need help to start from the top, and then you start from the bottom, you put it down, and then you start putting it up. You start from the top. The Amos is brought down that this is only dealing with when you have, I don't have exactly the tzir, because you're like creating walls on the side. I would think like, you're creating the fire that you have you put woods on, call a bonfire. But over here, it seems to be that you have walls on the side and you're setting it up on the walls. I don't have the exact tzir. But the Nekudas HaDvarim is you can't set it up in a normal fashion, which you set it up on the bottom and then on top, but you start with the top and you go to the bottom. The Chen HaGdera, if you want to set up a Gdera also, so you want to make a fire under the Gdera, so you put up some stones and then you're going to use these stones as a stove, so to speak, and you can make the fire under the stove. So here again, you don't set up the stones and then put the Gdera on top of the stones, you hold the Gdera, then you put the stones under the Gdera. The Chen HaGdera, Oichiz Oisa, Umachnus Avonim Tachta. So the male, it's a Shimi. So you have the bed itself, and then you have the crushim, which are the holding the bed on top, and then you have the legs of the bed. So amita is oiches hakrushim lemaila, and then a machnisim haraglaim tachteim. You don't set up the legs and then put the meat on top of it, but fakert, you set up the meat on top. You have to hold it, and then you set up the legs under it. Afilu beitzim. If you want to set up like a pile of eggs, it's also not Elishana. So you start, not 100% sure how you do it. I mean, person's Mamaila Lamata, it's holding the egg and putting the egg under it. I don't have the exact tier of how a person would deal with setting up these eggs. Halacha Tezayin, Misirin Zvuvin Hanitlim Bebehema. Because you have zvuvim, fleas, that are attached to the behema, and there's a concern, it's not a secretion, it's a concern that they make chabura, so the din is you're allowed to pull them off, because it's a sarba behema, and it's a enemus chab, it's not a secretion. The ein miyaldness a behema biyontif, to actually be miyaled, notice to stick your hand in, into the rechem of the behema, and pull out the vlad is usher. Avu Musad, to help the behemoth, that's mutakated. Eches bevlad shleep alor. It's while the vlad is coming out of the behemoth, you're allowed to hold it in order it shouldn't fall down. You could blow it into its nose, in other words, for it to start breathing. Avinason dad la tech piv, you could put the udder into its mouth for it to start getting milk. Hoysa behemoth teira, vericha kesavlad. If you have a behemoth teira, and that behemoth teira was meraki the vlad. For some reason or another, the mother is not interested in the vlad. So there's a din muter lezalif mishul yasa olav. You could take the placenta and pour it on top of the vlad, and through that the mother will smell it, and the mother will be merachim on this vlad. So I said that through taking some of this shilya and pouring it on top of the vlad, the mother is going to stop being merachim on the vlad. And also the litan bul melech berachma, you put a bunch of salt, a ball of salt into the rechem, into the womb of the animal. Because through that bul melech, she'll remind herself of the tzar haleda, and that'll cause her to be merachem on the vlad. That's by a behema tehera. It's not going to help. Loshna ina tzricha means it's not necessary. But the Magen Mishnah says that the pshat is that there's no necessity in this pula because it's not going to help. A behema tehera, even though it was merachim the vlad, but eventually it could be chayzer merachim. Mashenkin a behema tmeya, once she was merachim, she's not going to be mitare. Okay. Halacha yudzayin. Keli shenitma me'erev yontif is ein madbil nesim yontif. Gzeira. Shem, not because of the din of tikkun. The lepel, the chacham made an isser of tikkun. But the reason why the Chacham made this Isra is not really a Tikkun Gomer. The reason that the Chacham made this Isra of Tikkun through Tefillah, because Shem Yasha Isra B'Tumasi. Because the concern, Chassal wanted that you should do everything that you're supposed to do before Yom Tov. So if the din is going to be there, you could be toivel on yontif. You could be toivel the keli on yontif. So a person has a keli that's done. He'll think, what do I have? Before yontif, I have other things to do. On yontif, I'll be toivel it. So he says, no, shema yashay sebitamasi. The water that's in the keli, you need to be matkul. You know, the water became tummy. There's no iser. There's no iser to be toivel water on yontif. Toivel water doesn't really mean tefillah. Toivel water means connecting the water with the mikvah. In other words, b'chlal, food and drink, once they became tummy, they cannot become tor. The only thing that become tor is water through ashoka, because when the water becomes connected to the mikvah, it's not the tefillah, it's the connection. So v'mhoye tzorech lahatvul ma'im shebei, is matvul is hakeli, you want to connect the water, so you put the keli into the mikvah, b'meimav, v'inecheshesh, and the fact that the keli is also going to become tor, is b'seit. Keli shall you tor l'truma, v'rotzel adbila l'kedesh, there's a din, a keli, even though you were tevel it, but you have to be tevel it in order to be able to use kosher with the keli, even though it's tor, and it was you tevel it for truma, but you have to have special in mind to be tevel it l'kedesh. So now you were tevel already this keli, the keli is tor, but now you want to be tevel it in order with the das to make it kedesh. It's not really a serious tikkun. Is mutal adbila, that level of tevela is mutal. The chen kol ki etzbezem tefillah shara milas, things that are batsim tor, is just certain milas that they made that you need an extra tefillah. Halacha yudches, that's what we're talking about. Halacha yudzayin keli shnitnum erev yontif. So you could have been tevel erev yontif. So Chazal say you can't be tevel on yontif. Hashenkin keli shnitnum biyontif is matbil nesi biyontif. Nitma hakeli b'mashkin tmeim shehem vlada tumim erev yontif. So there's a special din that mashke could be metame keli midrabonan. So if they were nitma b'mashkin tmeim, shein vlada tum erev yontif, says also matbil neis v'yontif. That level of tum is also tumut to be table. Lefishi yutor b'minaterik, mishi yizbor b'mkeim, it's only a tum d'rabbonon, that mashke tmeim could be matan mekeli, because mashke tmeim is only a rishon. And so therefore, and a keli can be nistami only from an av, but nevertheless, so that's only a yisod d'rabbonon, so you're allowed to be table on yontif. Umadlin bidli, if you should term an atheric mission, is born in Madeline, but Lee Tommy, who term me, if you have a pail that you bring down into the well and you're drawing water from the well, so the vial of the pail is going into the water, so mail is becoming Taurus, that's also the same. Nida Shain Lob Godam Lahachlus, so Nida is Tmeya, and her Godam are also Tommy, and she doesn't have other Godam, so she wants to be Taibel or Godam, she wants to wear Godam which are Taurus. So she'in lo b'godim v'achlev is maremes v'tivel is b'b'godah. So to be tevel herself, she's allowed. Ma she'in can be tevel her b'godim, she's not allowed to, because you know how to be matbul dover, it was tamei erev yontif. So the etzah is that she's tevel herself, and while she's tevel herself, she's going into the mikvah and with the b'godim, so the b'godim become tired as well. Halacha yutes, dvarim rabim osir b'yontif, mishum gzeiras mekach u'mamkar, ketzat. Ain't poiskim domin lechatchila ala behemah biyontif. You want to take a behemah from someone, you want to get, and so you want to know what the price is. So you don't make up a price. Ella, maybe shtei behemah shavazul lezul. V'sheichten achas mehan u'mechalkim b'neim. U'lemachar yedin kamer d'mei ashniya. V'cholechad v'echad nesin d'mei chalkis. Now, since originally you had two animals which were very similar, so you took one of those animals, and it's understood that tomorrow we'll assess how much the other animal's worth, which is the same as the first, and then how much each one took, and then we'll be able to figure out how much you owe. When they divide, you're not taking the whole animal, you're taking the divide. Those I want meat worth of a seller, or you'll take meat worth of two sloim. When you divide it, you don't mention any types of money. You say, I'm taking a third of the animal, a fourth of the animal. You speak about the part of the animal, how much of the animal you're taking, but you don't speak about the prices that you're taking. When you divide the meat with each other, you want to know how much each one took. So the best thing to see is how much weight each one took. So he says, no, you shouldn't weigh them. You're not allowed to use a kaf mizna'im whatsoever. If you have a scale that's hanging, and that's how they use the scale, Lapel, you're putting it into the scale, not because you want to weigh, because you want to watch it. You want it should be above the ground, and the mice shouldn't be able to get to it. Nevertheless, you're not allowed to. You're not allowed to put anything, any meat into a scale, or any food into a scale, or anything into a scale. The tabach uman, oster lishkel biyadi. So if a person is a professional, so he could, just holding it, he could already weigh. He knows exactly how much it weighs. Is a tabach uman, oster lishkel biyadi. And also, the oster lishkel bekeli moli mayim. You know, there's another way of measuring. By putting you have a keli full of water, and you put the meat into the keli, and you see how much water is distilled, and then you can figure out how much the weight of the meat is. So you're not allowed to do that as well. They matilin chaloshna lamonis, and to make lots, in others, you want to make a girl, you're dividing the parts, and you make a girl is also awesome. Avu matilin chaloshin al psara kochim biyontiv, kidei lechavdus ha-mitzvah. Those the canim among themselves, when they're dividing psara kochim, mitzat chibuv ha-mitzvah, they're allowed to use lots, lottery yeastis, to be able to divide the different parts of the animal. The kudus advarim is, you're not allowed to deal with any types of buying and selling on yontiv, because a gzera, a mecha chomemker, is also beyontiv, which is gzera's mecha chomemker. Yeah. And b'chlal, gzera's mecha chomemker is also, it's at chash ksiva, we learned already in Hilchos Shabbos. Halacha chof aleph. Le'yemer adam le'tabach tenli b'dinner baser, ele tenli chelik echatzi chelik. Before we were told when people divide amongst each other. A person goes to the butcher, and he asks him, "I want to have a dinner worth of meat." So he doesn't do that. He has to give him, "I want a portion, a chatzi portion." Le'nocher eisa cheshbon al shavi, v'chein le'yikach b'malachanus b'midei b'mishkol. Ele ketsu du'esa emo le'chendin imali le'keli zeh. He doesn't say, "Give me a quart of milk." He has to say, fill me up this keli. Then he gives him the value of what he took. Even if he gives him a measuring cup, is malenu? Because we're not speaking about any mida. We're just saying, fill me up this keli. So you come, they would come with a keli and it would be filled up. The question, how much should I give you? So you don't say how much as far as the measurement is concerned. Just fill me up this keli. Since he's baking, cooking in large quantities, and therefore he's going to make a mistake in the amount, so he can have a big hefset. So therefore, he's allowed to measure the spices that he needs for the food that he's cooking. Avalisha, which is cooking in smaller amounts, and mele, it's not such a big difference if it's a little bit more or a little less. Is leitamud kemachlisa? She shouldn't measure how much kemach she's using for the dough, even though it does make a little difference, but it doesn't make that much of a difference. Shouldn't measure how much seirim is given to the behemah. Ela mishar v'nesla, he assesses it and he gives. Umuter likach menachem v'ni beitzim v'gezim v'minyin. You could say how many eggs or how many nuts. V'chein kol kietzim v'n. Abro bulvad shel yiskele shemdomim v'lischuminyin. Because you could go to a chemni and take from him and tell him, I want a dozen eggs. Or I want 10 nuts. But on the other hand, you shouldn't tell him the price. You shouldn't speak out a price. And you shouldn't also say a schum minyan. Kate, what does schum minyan mean? You already owed him 10 pomegranates. Or 10 nuts. Give me another 10 nuts. You know, I owe you 10 nuts. Now I'll owe you 20. Just takes from him the 10. Because sometimes it's more comfortable, you know, you want to tell the person, listen, I acknowledge that I still owe you, and I'm going to owe you more, and I'm telling you how much I'll owe you. It's easier to do that. So you shouldn't do that on Yontif. Alekech stam, ulemacher esechesh. Halacha chav dalet. Heilech odom etzel roya harogel etzle, etzel apatam harogel etzle. There's someone that you normally take meat from, or behemoths from, or apatam is someone that feeds stuffs, that force feeds an animal, it becomes fat. Till now we were speaking about going to a tabach and taking meat, maybe before he was talking about dividing together, now he's speaking about taking a whole animal. That's the chiddush over here. That he goes to someone that he's used to and he takes from an animal. Halvas yontif tevenei sibidim. Well, will be that a person comes and he says, give me some food. And the person gave him food. They never made up a price. And the next day he says, well, I thought, you know, you give me a present. So we say no, that when you give someone a food on yontif, it's understood that you're expected to pay for it. She'im teimali nitnali tava. If you're going to say that since we didn't make up a price, so therefore you could tie there was a present, so then a person will never give. So knows it's l'tevas, the recipient, that the rule should be that the giver should be able to take the money from the recipient in order for the recipient to get. Afal pi she'ein magbi and trumas umaisis biyantiv. You now be mafish trumas umaisis. Abin imhoyeli trumas umaisis she'igbi and miyamesh is areza milichon l'kayin biyantiv. You could bring it to the kayin, and as you have it, it's his, and you can bring it to him. Ve'ein tzorech leima chala zreo l'chayayim v'keva. With shemilichon liyontif, shemilichon came biyontif, because chala you could be mafresh on yontif. You could be mafresh chala on yontif if it was baked on yontif. It was baked out of yontif, you can't be mafresh. But if it was baked on yontif, you're allowed to be mafresh. And zreil l'chayim v'keva, you could always be mafresh because zreil l'chayim v'keva, the matonis, which are really, it's clear in the animal where they are, and they're not really being mat to the animal because the animal is mutl before you give it. So b'kitzur, you're allowed to bring Trumas and Isis, which you had from yesterday, you can take Chala, Zreel, Chayayim, Bekeva, which you mafish today, even you give it to the yontif, to the Kain on yontif. The Gabay Tzedaka, Gaven, Menachatzeir is biyontif. Abavilei, Machrizen, Kederach, Machrizen, Bechel, Gaven, Betzinah. So on yontif, the Gabay comes and he takes food from the people. The Nason, Letech, Chaykon, he doesn't bring the big Kail, he just puts it into his Chayk, he puts it into his pocket or to wherever. On him, you don't take, you know, first you gather from everybody, and then you're going to start being mechalik with everybody. That's already too much of a tumult. You do it betzina, in the middle you take from one chutzer, and then you divide it, and then you take from the other area, and then you divide it.